السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهديه الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه بلغ الأمانة وأدى الرسالة ونصح الأمة فكشف الله به الغمة وتركنا على المحاجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك فاللهم يا أرحم الراحمين اجمعنا به في أعلى عليين مع النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين وحسن أولئك رفيقا اللهم آمين. My dear brothers and sisters, we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the sifa that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has left us with a clear message. A clear message that will get us all the way to Jannah. A clear message that will put us on the straight path. And he said alayhi salatu wa salam, تَرَكْتُ فِيكُمْ مَا إِنْ تَمَسَّكْتُمْ بِهِ لَنْ تَضِلُّ بَعْدِي أَبَدًا. I have left amongst you something, if you follow us step by step, you will never go misguided. What is it, Ya Rasulullah? Kitab Allahi wa Sunnati. The book of Allah and the Sunnah, the traditions of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. قال الله تعالى في كتابه العزيز يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. Oh, you believe? Fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how we ought to be feared and never die except in the status of complete submission. The status of complete submission to who? To Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the orders of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To the orders of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters, we're living through the best days of the year. Allah has blessed us to be part of these days. Allah has blessed us to be alive in these days. And in a couple of days, on Tuesday will be the day of Arafah. And on Wednesday will be the day of Eid, Yawm al-Nahr. Some of the best days of the year. And these two special days is honored in the Quran and Sunnah. Today's topic is the importance of the day of Arafah and Ahkam al-Udhiyah and the regulations around the sacrifice that comes in the next day, the day of Nahr. My dear brothers and sisters, these two days, especially the day of Arafah, is honored in so many ways. The day of Arafah was mentioned in the Quran as part of Al-Ashhur al-Hurum. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ. Allah mentioned that there are four sacred months. There are four sacred months. And it happened that the day of Arafah is part of Dhul Hijjah, which is the month of, one month of the sacred month. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has honored the day of Arafah as part of the days of Hajj. Allah mentioned in the Quran, لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ وَلِيَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ وَيَذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ. Ibn Abbas rahimahullah, رضي عنه, he mentioned that أَيَّامٌ مَعْلُومَاتٍ is referring to the 10 days of the Hijjah. These 10 days, Allah is mentioning that it is preferred to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these days, in all shapes and forms. My dear brothers and sisters, these 10 days, and including the day of Arafah, as it was mentioned in another hadith that was narrated by Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من أحبها أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام, يعني أيام العشر. The Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned, there are no days that the good deeds are beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than these 10 days. And the day of Arafah takes a special case, and we'll talk more about that today. But it's included within these 10 preferable days. No special good deed, no worship, no act of worship is more beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than these days. My dear brothers and sisters, this day is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has fulfilled His ni'mah, His grace, His bounty upon the believers. ورد في الأثر that عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه was narrated in the tradition that عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه was told by a Jewish man. He said, يا أمير المؤمنين آية في كتابكم تقرؤونها لو علينا معشر اليهود نزلت لاتخذنا ذلك اليوم عيدا. A man, a Jewish man, came to Amir al-Mu'mineen Umar ibn al-Khattab, and he said, one ayah that was revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that you read in the Quran, that if it was revealed to us Jews, we will be celebrating that day as a day of Eid. What was the response of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu? He said, ayya ayah, which ayah? The Jew said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. The ayah translates is, today I have perfected your religion for you and have completed my favor upon you and have approved Islam as a religion for you. عمر بن الخطاب, he responded and said, قد عرفنا ذلك اليوم الذي نزلت فيه على النبي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو قائم بعرفة يوم الجمعة. We know that day it was revealed to Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم in the day of Arafah, when he was standing in the day of Jum'ah on Arafah during the Hajj, the one Hajj that Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم performed. So this day, the day of Arafah, was honored with this ayah that Allah completed the deen in this day. My dear brothers and sisters, this is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala releases a lot of the nafs from the hellfire. This is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will show that the creations of heaven to the malaika and say, This is my worshippers. My dear brothers and sisters, in the hadith that was narrated by Aisha radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, in this hadith that was narrated by the mother of the believers, Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, مَا مِنْ يَوْمْ قَالَ قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ She says that رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ said, مَا مِنْ يَوْمٍ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَنْ يُعْتِقَ اللَّهُ فِيهِ عَبْدًا مِنَ النَّارِ مِنْ يَوْمِ عَرَفَةَ وَإِنَّهُ لَيَدْنُو ثُمَّ يُبَاهِي بِهِ بِالْمَلَائِكَةِ فَيَقُولُ مَا أَرَادَ هَؤُلَاءِ The translation goes, Aisha radiallahu anha, she reported that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, there is no day when God, when Allah set free more servants from the hellfire than the day of Arafah. And he draws near, meaning that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala draws near in the heaven of the dunya. And he would praise his worshippers. And he would say to his angels, مَاذَا أَرَادَ هَؤُلَاء In a way that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is honoring and proud that his ibad, his worshippers are in front of his door asking for his mercy. And in front of his door making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, making dhikr, making ibadat, praying for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, reading the Quran. So this is a day that you should be honored with these people. Watch yourself what you do in these days. These 10 days, and specifically the day of Arafah. Are you going to be part of the ibad, the worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will be honored that day or not? Brothers, listen, inshallah, come forward, inshallah. There's plenty of brothers waiting in the door, and there's some spaces in the middle. So if we can, please, see space in front of you, تقدموا, inshallah. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ تَفَسَّحُوا فِي الْمَجَالِسِ فَفَسَّحُوا يَفْسَحِ اللَّهُ لَكُمْ جَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا So look at yourself these days, these 10 days of the Hijjah. Look at yourself in the day of Arafah and see if you will be honored in the eyes of Allah in that day or not. Plan for that day to be honored and be part of those who honored in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of Arafah. My dear brothers and sisters, we talked about how the day of Arafah is having a high importance in the religion. طيب, what should we do in the day of Arafah? The first recommended action of worship is fasting the day of Arafah. عن أبي قتادة رضي الله عنه In the hadith that was narrated by أبي قتادة رضي الله عنه In صحيح مسلم, he says, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said, صيام يوم عرفة أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله والسنة التي بعده. In this hadith that was narrated by Abi Qatada عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the day of Arafah, it is reported that it will account in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you fast it, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive for you the 1 year before that day and the 1 year ahead. Now how many of you want to miss on that chance? Now how many of you want to miss on that chance? I'm sure it's not me. We all do sins all year around. We ask Allah for forgiveness and this is your chance to wipe clear every sin for the previous year and the coming year. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه ولي المستغفرين. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين ثم ما بعد My dear brothers and sisters, we talked about the importance of the day of Arafah in our deen. We talked about some of the ibadat that we need to focus on during the day of Arafah. We started with the siyam and we mentioned the hadith of Abi Qatada رضي الله عنه and Sa'id ibn Jubayr, one of the tabi'een, he says, سأل رجل عبد الله بن عمر عن صوم يوم عرفة One man asked Abdullah ibn Umar about the fasting day of Arafah. فقال كنا ونحن مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم نعدله بصوم سنتين. When we were with Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, we accounted that day for as if you fasted for 2 years. So nobody want to miss on this reward. Nobody want to miss in this tijara مع الله سبحانه وتعالى. This is your chance to gain huge reward back and at the same time clear out plenty of sins. My dear brothers and sisters, it was recommended in that day as well to do a lot of dhikr, especially the takbir. Takbir, takbir al-eid. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. La ilaha illa Allah, Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar wa lillahi alhamd. And the takbir, the scholars divided it into the two different ways of takbir. At-takbir al-muqayyad, the one that's restricted to after the salawat al-maktuba. And what's that? Not muqayyad. It is okay during any of the times during the 10 days. At-takbir al-muqayyad, the one that's restricted to after the salawat, it was mentioned that it is only after the fajr of Arafah all the way till the sunset of the 13th of Dhul Hijjah, the third day of Tashriq, the 13th of Dhul Hijjah. This is takbir al-muqayyad. This is after the salawat. طيب, takbir al-mutlaq. The takbir that you can do at any time throughout the day. The takbir al-muqayyad, the restricted one, it was narrated that the scholars, when you do it after the salah, is done in groups in the masjid. It's done in groups after jama'ah, in the house, anywhere else. But the one that you can do anytime, it was narrated that you have to do it individually, not necessarily in groups throughout the 10 days of Dhul-Hijjah. It was narrated that Ibn Umar radiallahu anhu and Abi Hurairah would go in the markets, would go in the asmaq, and they would say takbir to remind people to do takbir as well. They wouldn't necessarily, some people perceive this narration that Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Abdullah ibn Umar would stand in the middle of the souq and do takbir and the people will gather around them and do takbir. That's not the case. The case is, they will walk in the aswaq. That was the narration was saying, walk on the aswaq. And people will hear the takbir and do their takbir individually. So this is the different types of takbir that you can do throughout the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah and after as well. But you can do different ways of dhikr as well. Different ways of remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Doesn't have to be only takbir. Any way that you can remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah, subhanallah wa bihamdihi subhanallah al-azim. And one of the best du'a that was said in the day of Arafah is qawlu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the hadith that was narrated on Jaddi Amr ibn Shu'ayb, he says, kana akbaru du'a al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yawm Arafah. La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah, lahu al-mulk wa lahu al-hamd. وهو على كل شيء قدير. The best, عجد عمر بن شعيب, he narrated that the best dua that was frequently said by رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم during the day of Arafah is لا إله إلا الله. There is no God worthy of worship except Allah سبحانه وتعالى. وحده لا شريك له. Alone with no partners. له الملك. To him is the dominance of all kingdoms. وله الحمد. And to him is the praise. We have to praise him and thank him for everything that he gives us. وَهُوَ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ. And he can do everything and anything. So this is the best of the dua that you can say during the day of Arafah. So this is the importance of the day of Arafah in our deen. Now I'm going to transition inshallah and conclude with this. Some of the regulations and the conditions around the udhiyah, the sacrifice during Yawm al-Nahr. So the first condition for any sacrifice that you've given during the day of Eid is it has to be of an age, of a certain age. In the hadith that was narrated by Jabir رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تذبحوا إلا مسنة إلا أن يعصر عليكم فتذبحوا جذعة من الضأن. In this hadith that was narrated by Jabir radiallahu anhu قال, he said, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, sacrifice only a full grown animal unless it is difficult for you, in which case you can sacrifice a she lamb. A jabir means within 6 months, at least 6 months of age, lamb. This is the lowest. And when you talk to the scholars, you'll see that they define what is musinna, a full grown animal for each of al an'am, for each of the animals that you can sacrifice in the day of Eid. As for the ibn, as for the camels, it was said it has to be at least 5 years. As for the baqar, as for the cows, it was said that it has to be at least 2 years. As for the ma'iz, the goats, it has to be at least 1 year. The one exception below the 1 year is the butt, the lamb, it could be at least 6 months. So this is the first condition of the udhiyya. The second condition of the udhiyya, it has to be in good condition. You're sacrificing this for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It shouldn't be having any defects. This udhiyya, it was narrated by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. في حديث البراء بن عازب قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أربع لا تجزئ في الأضاحي: العوراء البين عررها، والمريضة البين مرضها، والعرجاء البين ضلعها، والكثيرة التي لا تنقي. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم says there are four types of an'am that you cannot sacrifice in the day of Eid. The one-eyed animal that is obvious blind in one eye, the sick animal that's obviously sick, the lame animal which obviously limping in one foot, and the animal that's abnormally thin or weak. So an animal that you're sacrificing for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala during the day of Eid, it has to be clear for any defects. And the last condition, that the udhiyya has to be slaughtered after salatul Eid, and you have the time all the way to the sunset of the 13th of the Hijjah to slaughter your udhiyah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this udhiyah is sunnah. It's not mandatory. You don't have to sacrifice an animal in the day of Eid. If you are able to fulfill the sunnah, that's good. It's not fard. It's sunnah. So don't make it fard. Don't complicate things for yourself if you're not able. The udhiyah itself is only sunnah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our ibadat. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our adahi. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us for all our sins. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala aid us to worship Him the best way possible in these 10 days. Allahumma aghfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit Allahumma ala al-haqq aqdamana wa ansurna ala man adana ولا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا ولا إلى النار مصيرنا ولا تسلط علينا بذنوبنا من لا يخافك فينا ولا يرحمنا. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. اللهم أعنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك. ربنا لا تزغ قلوبنا بعد إذ هديتنا وهب لنا من لدنك رحمة إنك أنت الوهاب. هذا وإن كان من تقصير فمني ومن الشيطان، وإن كان من توفيق من الله فمن الله، وأعوذ بالله أن أذكركم به وأنساه. وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا.